What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Monty Python. And we're going to listen to another sketch included on the final rip-off compilation, which, as I mentioned before, in terms of mileage or hours listening to, it's probably the Monty Python content which I've re-listened to and re-listened to the most over the years, more than I've re-watched episodes of the show, although, as I mentioned, I have seen a large number of episodes, probably not all of them, but a great number of them. I have, DVDs. I used to have VHS tapes of multiple movies of theirs, Holy Grail, and Life of Brian in particular. I think I have Meaning of Life somewhere. But yeah, like I said, in terms of the amount of time I've spent engaged with Monty Python, most of it has been audio only, and in particular, the final ripoff was, a compilation I got in my early teens, I want to say. And I just listened to the heck out of it for the next, decade or more, right up into the present day, pretty much. Again, I've gotten some other albums, including a few that I never had back in the day, which have some bits that are included, at least in some ways. Like, I've now found out that some of the, transitions are changed, and that leads to little bits at the beginning or end being altered or left off. So yeah, ultimately, and in fact, it's a decent segue into talking about the one we're going to listen to now, which is Are You Embarrassed Easily? Which is a hilarious, it sounds like, public service recording, maybe for Swedish radio. I think Michael Palin is the person who plays the narrator, and I think his name is Dr. Carl Gruber. I want to say he's presented as Swedish. But yeah, ultimately, it goes through a series of embarrassing words or sounds and then scenarios in that order. And, with each escalating the level of potential embarrassment, but the rubrics which he presents to indicate your level of embarrassment or the gradations of embarrassment are absurdist categories that make no sense. Hi, hello, and good evening, which, I'm not sure which one would actually be more, but it does lead me to say that at the end of this, the end of that sketch, normally it ends with a good evening, but in this case, the last moment, the last phrase, which is a much heavier good evening, comes at the beginning of the next track, because they use it as the beginning of the next bit. So it's like, hi, hello, good evening, and that begins the next bit, and so is the good evening is included on the next track. So I believe we won't get the final moment of the sketch. But yeah, it's just absurdist. It's Michael Palin at his most hilarious. And admittedly, the words they pick are well chosen, the sounds they pick are well chosen, and then, the implications, even without any visuals, the implications of the scenarios, are equally funny. So, and in fact, I think they only do one scenario. Nevertheless, let's get to it. This is Monty Python, Are You Embarrassed Easily?, heard here as part of the final rip-off compilation.
Are you embarrassed easily? I am. But it's nothing to worry about. It's all part of growing up and being British. This course is designed to eliminate embarrassment,
and yes, this is Eric Idle,
to enable you to talk freely about rude objects, to look at awkward and embarrassing things, and to point at people's privates. The course has been designed by Dr. Carl Gruber of the Institute of Going a Bit Red in Helsinki.
He's finished.
Here,
that's right.
He himself introduces the
My
course.
Bad.
Hello, my name is Carl Gruber. Thank you for inviting me into your home. My method is the result of 6 years' work here at the Institute, in which subjects were exposed to simulated embarrassment predicaments over a prolonged fart. Period. Time. Sorry. Lesson one. Words. Do any of these words embarrass you?
Shoe. Megaphone. Grunties.
Now let's go on to something ruder.
Wankel rotary engine.
Now lesson two, noises. Noises are a major embarrassment source. Even words like tits, winkle, and vibraphone cannot rival the embarrassment potential of sound. Fair. Listen to this, if you can.
Give this one.
How do you rate your embarrassment response? A, hi. B, hello. C, good evening. If C, you are loosening up and will soon be ready for this. Well, How did you rate?
I like his
A,
laughter.
Embarrassed. B, hello. C, good evening. Now lesson three, in which these rude and dirty sounds are combined with smutty visual suggestions into an embarrassment simulation situation. You are the waiter at this table.
Simulation situation.
Charles, I've got something to show you.
Unzip.
Score 5 for no embarrassment. Score 3 for slight embarrassment. And 1 for...
Good evening. And I forgot the last bit. They changed up a bit, but then they come back with the good evening, which, as I said, is put into the next track. It's hilarious. I forgot there was that opening bit from Eric Idle introducing it, and that line, that, you know, it's all part of growing up and being British. Fair to say, I know that's, a long-running stereotype, but I don't think the UK has a monopoly on embarrassment as people grow older. I think that is a universal human trait. Nevertheless, it's hilarious, and again, like, some of the sounds, it's like, okay, so where did you record that? Exactly what did you do? Like, you know, the one where it's like a fast, wet sort of sound, a mouse sound, it does sound like you could maybe do the cheek things to do that, but there are other parts of that where it's like, all right, so where did you get that recording? I love the bit at the end with, you know, a clear implication of something, a couple of things falling onto the table, and then another sound that I'm not quite sure what's happening. It sounds like maybe a balloon or something expanding. It maybe also sounds like liquid going into a pan or something. I'm not sure what's going on, so I'll rate my embarrassment as good evening. Nevertheless, do let me know what you think of this one, and I'll see you for the next Monty Python. Peace.